All right, my people, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you're hearing us from. We have come again to tell you that we are moving on a main life. All right, we told you Nigeria is a terrorist country, and you are not, trying to believe or accept, but here it is. We come with evidence. We not explain without evidence. All right. What we have here from People's Gazette says 24 U.S. organizations petition Blinken to designate Nigeria as CPC over mass killing of Christians. What is CPC? CPC is country of particular concern over the murder of hundreds of Christians. You see, let me read what I have here. Please follow me to the end. It says at least 24 interest organizations, which include religious groups led by Advancing America Freedom, Alliance Defending Freedom, and Houston Hudson Institute, former Ambassador Sam Brownback, and former defense and national security officials call for action against Nigeria over the killings. The group recalled the suspected herdsmen attack on Plateau communities during the Yuletide season. Over 150 people were killed on Christmas Eve. Less than 2 weeks ago, almost 200 Nigerian Christians became martyrs while celebrating Christmas. According to one account, these Christians were killed for sports. Just weeks earlier, the Christian Association of Nigeria received a letter threatening them against celebrating Christmas. The International Religious Freedom Community stands outraged at your refusal to hold this act of evil to account, the organization said. They added, the eyes of the world look to the United States as a beacon of hope and freedom. Religious freedom is grounded in American founding, enshrined in the Bill of Rights, and quintessential to what it means to be an American. When the United States stands silent as evil runs amok, the world takes notice. The push to list Nigeria as a CPC came after a Catholic-inspired think tank group, InterSociety, claimed that the Islamic militants have brutally murdered at least 52,250 Christians in the last 14 years. Led by its director, Emeka Umar-Balasi, the human rights advocacy group claimed that over 500 Christians were killed last year in January alone. It accused the Nigerian government at various levels and complicity in the killings of the worshippers, predicting that the most populous African nation may be one of the brink of the religious war. On January 4th, Mr. Blinken announced that he would designate some countries, including Iran, Russia, as CPC. However, Nigeria, notable for religious crisis and killing, was left off the list. According to Pew Research, Nigeria has the largest Christian population of any country in Africa, with over 80 million believers. In December 2019, the U.S. placed Nigeria on its special watch list over the government's tolerance of severe violence of religious freedom. Then, the blacklisting did not come until December 2020, when the U.S. finally designated Nigeria as CPC under immediate past President Muhammadu Buhari, following the spate of killings and brutal murder in the north. The designation could attract economic issues for Nigeria. The American government could deny Nigeria credit loans under OPIC by directing the executive directors of the international financial institutions to oppose and vote against loans primarily benefiting the foreign governments. The U.S. government could also deny Nigerian exports under certain instruments, such as Arm Export Control Act. It could also prohibit America from procuring goods and services from the country. All right, that's what we have here right now. These people, oh yes, they need to designate Nigeria as a country of particular concern in the killings of Nigerian Christians. Of course, and indigenous people. Remember, Igbos are mostly Christians, dominated Christians, and then they are indigenous people. Even the people in Jos, they are mostly Christians. When you see them attack people, check that region very well. That region is Christian-based community. And now, Blinken is the one that has taken so much bribe over the years. He is the one that delisted Nigeria from the CPC countries. And even that, we are talking about disintegration of Nigeria, because you cannot merge Muslims with Christians and they will not want to dominate. Right, so it is better we separate them, because the longer you keep this, the more they force people to their religion. You don't force people to any religion. What you do is to preach to people. You don't force them, you don't kill them, because what they were taught, you know, they have this mindset of kill them, they are infidels, kill them or force them to your religion. It is religion of force. Let no man deceive you. Even one of them said it, that if you allow this Muslim ticket, then Nigeria is heading to darkness. So if someone from that religion could say such a thing, is it you that know that what he's saying is true will not believe what he's saying? Who has deceived you? Onyeriruno, who has eaten you up that you don't even understand, or you don't even think towards freedom, you don't even think towards what will work for you? I mean, what will work for you, you. Why are you not thinking towards that? The best approach, the best thing to do right now is this self-referendum. We must join hands. If we join hands and declare that this is where we stand, my dear, the whole world has no power over us, because we have been warning them, we have been enlightening them about this, and they say nothing. Their silence is no longer golden and will no longer be considered, will no longer be taken. We have taken our stand that Biafra must come, and we must have to worship our God, Chukwuekike Abiama, in the way he wants us to worship him, not in the way the devil is trying to do it. No, God deserves our worship, and in the way he deserves it. He has that right over any being, all right, because he created all things. Chukwuekike Abiama happened to be God we are talking about, not any other God. All right, please help us to share this very video, like it, and help us to subscribe to this channel. Please don't go anywhere.